Good evening, and welcome to Legacy Hall.
We ask at this time that you please silence all cell phones and noise-making devices. Also, if you must leave, please do so during the end of the applause, in between pieces, and lastly, please no unauthorized audio or video during the performance. Thank you, and enjoy the performance.
in this concert, I thought about why these particular pieces had been written. That first piece was actually commissioned by a sextet, string quartet, clarinet, and piano, who were Russian. They were about to go on their tour of America, so they asked their friend Prokofiev to write them a piece, and not only did they ask him to write them a piece, but they gave him a set of Jewish folk tones and said, please use these. And Prokofiev said, no thanks, I write my own themes for the music that I'm going to write, thank you. But then he couldn't help his curiosity, and he went ahead and started making sketches, and he wrote that piece in 2 days. It turned out later that they weren't actual Jewish folk tunes. The clarinetists had actually written them, but too late. The reason for the next piece is friends. Mozart had a really good friend whose daughter was apparently an excellent pianist, and so he wrote this for her to play the piano bar. His good friend Anton Stadler played the clarinet at the premiere. He wrote the famous concerto and the clarinet quintet for Stadler, and Mozart himself played the viola part at the premiere. And you'll see in the program it's called the Kegelstadt Trio. Kegelstadt is the place, the ground on which they would play the sort of nine-pin bowling game. And so the legend was that Mozart had written it while playing bowling. But it turned out, we know that's completely not true. That was a different piece. But the publisher decided that maybe it would sell more copies if it like had a story. So he put the word Kegelstadt on it. And even though I myself know it's not true, I still put it in the program because now it's less known as the Kegelstadt Trio. So moral of that story, branding works, even if it's wrong. But I liked the fact that it's written for friends because I'm playing this with two new friends tonight. These two are new faculty members at the Schwab School. They just arrived here this school year, and I think you're going to love hearing them play.
Thank you.
see in your program that Brahms died in 1897. And in 1890, he said he was going to retire from composing. I'd like to enjoy my old age. He was kind of a cranky old guy anyway, I think, his entire life, maybe because he was in love with another man's wife. But he did apparently make the statement that he would never undertake a marriage or an opera. So he was kind of a cranky guy. But he said in 1890, that's it, I'm done. And then he went to an orchestra concert in 1891, and he heard Richard Mühlfeld play the clarinet. And he was struck by Mühlfeld's sound and his playing. He said he was the best wind player he'd ever heard. And because of that, we have perhaps four of the greatest pieces of our repertoire. The trio with cello, the quintet, the string quartet, and the two sonatas, one of which you're about to hear. And he wrote this in 1894, which is just 3 years before he died. So students, if you meet composers here that you like, be nice to them. You never know what they could do for you. Thanks again for coming tonight.
Thank you.